Hey guys, welcome to the Feng Shui Basics series where I'm going to teach you classical Feng Shui in an easy to understand way. Welcome to the Feng Shui Basics series where I'll teach you classical Feng Shui in a really easy to understand way. This series is more about the technical side of Feng Shui and the theory behind it. So if you'd like to learn more of an educational setting, then this series is perfect for you.
Make sure to support the channel. You hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the little alert icon so you can be alerted when new videos come out.
So welcome to video number one in my first of a Feng Shui Basics series. It really occurred to me because I had a lot of questions asking me about basic concepts. I really love more advanced concepts and I think they're really cool and really fun and interesting to work with. But it really occurred to me that I've had so many questions about some basic stuff that I would go back to basics a little bit and teach basic theory. So Feng Shui theory, it really is all about when you're first starting out, you know, you have these abstract concepts, you know. I like to kind of compare it to making slime. So my daughter went on this kick for like 3 years where she was making like every kind of slime possible, you know, like glow in the dark slime, glitter slime, you know, mixed different, like we make a cinnamon scented slime one time for Christmas. And so she's just making all these different slimes. And so it really kind of occurred to me that Feng Shui is kind of like slime, okay? When you're making slime, if you have a kid that is a fan of making slime or, you know, or was, you'll know that there's like three basic ingredients for slime. You need some glue, you need probably some water to mix it with, and like borax or like dish soap. There's some different things you can do to solidify it. So when you first start making it though, before you mix it in, it's really sticky and it kind of gets everywhere, you know? And when you start mixing it with your hand, you'll just have like glue all over your hand, you know? And until you get the ratio of borax to glue correct. And Feng Shui is kind of like that. You start with these ideas and they're really sticky. They're really sticky and you know, they're not really solid yet. You don't understand how to put it all together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk to you about just some basic theory and concepts and just some very basic ideas of where classical Feng Shui comes from and take, you know, that stickiness will start to kind of dissolve until we add the right ratio of knowledge in for you, okay? And then it'll start making sense and it'll be more solid, okay? So that's kind of where that is. So with saying that, today I'm going to talk about the direction. So I'm going to talk about each direction and the trigram associated with it and a little bit of, you know, what it represents in the element and stuff like that. So without further ado, here we go. So video number one here, again, talking about the elements. This concept comes from what is called the Bagua. So you may have seen a Bagua mirror. However, it's a little bit different. This Bagua mirror, it actually represents what is called an early heaven Bagua. Early heaven Bagua is a concept I don't really want to get into right now because it does have its place in Feng Shui, but right now we're going to focus on what is called the later heaven Bagua or the Lo Xu square. This Lo Xu square, this Bagua, is represented in a bunch of different ways. So you may see it as this Bagua mirror that is, it has the eight sides, it representing eight directions, or you may just see it represented as a box, or you can even see it represented as a pie shape. But basically it's all the same. Each one or each area just represents its own direction. So the Bagua is actually just a mathematical model of the way things look. So even though people use it and they might use a mirror to place over a doorway or something like that, that's actually more of a symbolism or type, you know, practice of Feng Shui. So what I'm going to teach you is the mathematical principle or concept behind this Bagua. The way I like to explain the directions is that each of them come from a hometown. So if you think about it, we all have our hometown, right? You know, some of you may have been born, you know, here I'm living in a little town in West Texas called Lubbock, Texas. But I was born in Glendale, Arizona, you know, so I'm from Glendale. That's my hometown. You know, you may have been born in Phoenix or, you know, LA or New York or wherever, right? So that's your hometown. That's where you're originally from, right? So each of these elements has a hometown that they're originally from. The energies can move around and they can be represented in different ways in different areas, but generally they have a hometown that they come from that they're originally from. So let's look at the original hometowns of the elements. I'm going to say the Chinese name. Each of these sectors or areas or even palaces as they're referred to sometimes, it really is just referring to the home base or hometown of each element. So let's, I'm going to say the Chinese name also. And just know if I ever say like gua or if I say palace or if I say direction, those all actually mean the same thing. The south is always seen on top of the lo shu or the bagua. And it's just always on top. Instead of seeing north on top, you'll see south on top. And the south is represented by two yang lines with one yin line in the middle. It's the element of fire and it's the li called Li Palace, L-I. Next, we'll go to the north, which is water. Water is represented by two yin lines with one yang line. It is the element of water, and it's pronounced Kan Palace. The direction of west, or Dui Palace, is the element of yin metal, and is represented by two yang trigrams, the two lines, with one yin line on top. The east is the element of yang wood, and it is the trigram, two yin lines at the bottom and one yang line on top, and it's pronounced Zhen Palace. Z-E-Z-H-E-N, Zhen. Let's now talk about the inner cardinal directions. Let's talk about southeast, southwest, northeast, and northwest. The southwest is called Kan Palace, and it's the element of yin earth. It's represented by three yin lines. The northwest is called Qian Palace. It's spelled Q-I-A-N and is the element of yang metal. And it's represented by three yang lines. The northeast is the element of yang earth and it's the Gen Palace. It's spelled G-E-N and its trigram is represented by two yin lines on bottom with one yin line on top. The southeast is the element of yin wood and it's pronounced Sun Gua or Sun Palace. Its trigram has two yang lines with one little yin line at the bottom. All right, guys, so just putting this information together for now, just think about this. Think about each element that's associated with the palace or the gua and think about it as the home base or the home palace of these elements. If you just think of it in this way, then you'll be able to kind of apply the concepts a little bit more. So just think about the element and the palace or the gua that it represents, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.